Morning, everyone. All right, so again, I'm gonna have my coffee and I'm gonna start packing my stuff and get my shit together because I'm out of here. Leaving St. Louis is always a happy moment for me. Off to Orlando I go. See you later. Here at the airport, getting ready. I'm just gonna have a quick something to drink before I get on the plane, and have about 20 minutes left. Then I'll be in Orlando, Florida. Can't wait. I'm going to meet my friend Phil, and you'll meet him when I get there. See ya. Okay, I'm here at Orlando Airport. I just landed. My flight arrived early, so I'm waiting for my friend Phil to come get me. So far, so good. It's nice and warm. And I will touch back base with you as soon as I know what's going on.
What's up, bitches? We are in Orlando. This is Philip. Say hi.
Okay. I gotta figure out how to get home.
So here is downtown Orlando. This is where Philip lived, and this is where I stayed for my trip. And one of my favorite places is just down the block. It's called Thornton Park. Out of all the places that we went to visit, I think I like Thornton Park the best, but I can't possibly see why I would live in Orlando, being that there's no beach or anything, unless I had some kind of big corporate position there, or it doesn't make sense. But these trees are gorgeous. And we're just gonna walk around the neighborhood for a while and check things out. Philip was nice enough to show me around, so I can get a better feel for what I would like and if I would like to live in Orlando, Florida. So the more I delve into different neighborhoods, the more I realize I am attracted more and more to these tree-lined street type of neighborhoods with historic homes. And I'll add that as we were walking and it was drawing closer to the mid-afternoon, it was getting really hot and humid out. I found this sign to be ironic. Even though I loved it, and if I was with no other options but to move to Orlando, I would definitely choose to live in this neighborhood. I really can't see why you would live there in that heat if you didn't have to work there or have some kind of high-end corporate position or work for Disney or something. Some kind of goal other than just, hey, I'm gonna live in Orlando for no good reason. Orlando would not be a viable option for me, and I must continue my search. But wow, huh? Look at that neighborhood. So pretty.
Philip, say hi, Phil. Actually taking a quick trip. We're going to Melbourne, Florida.
And then Cocoa Beach.
And those are going to be two of the areas that I'm going to check out to see if I would want to relocate to any of those areas. So here we are. So far, I'm in
Titusville.
Yeah, we're passing through Titusville. So far, I mean, it just looks kind of like industrial-ish, but I haven't seen much except for like the outskirts of Orlando and the highway.
And the marshlands.
So it's definitely something I'm not used to, being that I am more of a city girl. It's very interesting. I mean, I'm sure I'm gonna see the beach, and I won't care about anything else. So bit of what I'm looking at. I'm here in Melbourne, and we're in the historic district. Is this Main Street? Is it called Main Street?
Sure, I don't know. Yeah, it is.
So it's Main Street in Melbourne, and I'm having the pizza that my friend Philip, it's called Pizza Off the Tracks, and it's fantastic. And believe me, I'm a New Yorker, so I know good pizza when I try it, and there it is.
Why is it called Off the Tracks?
Because it's right near the train. That was actually on film before, so you'll hear it. Oh my god. Melbourne is a big maybe on my list of places, and so far it's my favorite.
I also saw on Main Street that Melbourne had some pretty cool storefront spaces available in case I wanted to start another business.
Oh my god, this is so random. This is so Florida. They sell jewelry and then they sell food and cigars and shit. This is so funny.
It's like a fusion cafe. What is this? Is this empty too?
There was this little thrift store that I could not pass up, and I went in, but unfortunately it wasn't so great.
Be like, look, Phil, I'm like...
They have some new condominiums going up right there. And that concludes our trip to historic Melbourne, and now we're off to Cocoa Beach.
Ask her for the name of her bar, okay?
Going to the beach. Cocoa Beach. I Dream of Jeannie. Oh my god, it was my favorite show. Down, yeah. I've been feeling so. I Dream of Jeannie used to be down, my favorite yeah. show. Can you tell me why? Can you tell me why? I'm Look, down. The yeah. sand. No There's Philip. No Hi, Philip. Now I'm thinking of. Now I'm thinking of. Oh, it's so beautiful. The breeze feels so good. It feels so nice. There's the pier, Cocoa Beach. I love the beach, but I don't know if I could live, like, if it would be beneficial to pay so much money to live near the beach if you're not, like, a dedicated beach goer. But I do love it. It smells great. That's right. That's what it really looks like when you're running back from the beach in slow-mo. Baywatch, the aftermath. And there it is. Therein lies the answer. I don't get to run on the beach like the girls in Baywatch, and I don't get to live on the beach like Frankie and Grace. I think it's safe to say that Florida is not for me. Oh, and then there's the hair problems.
My hair! Just look. I don't know if I can live here. Did you ever see that episode of Friends where they go to some tropical island? Monica's hair just keeps growing and growing and growing and growing until it's like this huge, giant disaster. That's what's happening to me slowly as we speak. Oh my God, my hair! I cannot live in Florida! Florida is out!
But one of the highlights of my trip was getting to see an old friend of mine. Her name is Nikki. She's actually my first female roommate, and I haven't seen her in a really long time. Really, really long time. So it was great to see her. I stopped by her job to surprise her, and we got to catch up. Unfortunately, I had to mute it because of copyright infringement. There is music playing in the bar. Sorry. Breaking news got me breaking. I was present, hopeless, praying. Struck down at 20, plenty left to put behind you. You ain't peaked, never speaking, now they speaking about you, leave it alone. Hope you grinning while you watch your bros on some soulful sunny shit to brighten up a wounded soul. Honest, you the penny, pick it up like Chevy, new age Machiavelli, disagree, don't tell me, now you in infinity, we 98, trust that he be good. On the ball like BB, don't make no mistakes, got the faith. The 18 just not gonna be the same. Finna be down generations, not gonna be in vain. Too young, why you gotta go, why you gotta go? I just wanna know. Well, it's time to get back home to my fur babies. Thank you so much for taking this journey with me. And the journey continues. I hope to see you in the next one. Please subscribe to my channel if you haven't already. Hit the bell so you can get those notifications. And don't forget to smash that like button. Leave your comments down below. I'd love to hear from you. And I'll see you soon.
Please subscribe and hit that bell.